Welcome back to the Fuji Guys, my name is Francis. So as you might know, Fujifilm is pretty well known for providing firmware upgrades to their cameras to extend the life of these cameras. So if you want to know more about these firmware upgrades, keep on watching. So these firmwares are for a couple of things, whether it's to fix some minor bugs in the firmware, improve the performance of the camera, or giving completely new feature. So for this video, we are going to use the X-H1 since it's the latest camera that received the firmware upgrade, and we'll go through the different updates that's been done to the firmware. So first of all, you need to go onto the website to download the firmware, which is FujifilmFirmware.com. From there, you can find the model of your camera and then download the file from the website onto the root of your memory card. And then you just put it in your camera and then begin the process, which is holding down the display back button and then powering on the camera. From there, you can just click and then upgrade your firmware. And after a few minutes, it's going to be done. So if we're talking about the X-H1, the first feature that's been added to this camera, which wasn't there before, is the ability to do focus bracketing. So you can shoot products, for example, at a wider aperture and then take multiple shots to have everything in focus from the foreground to the background. Next up is going to be a compatibility update. So as you might know, we just came out with two new MKX lenses, which are cinema lenses, perfectly suited for the X-H1, so that firmware allows these lenses to be compatible with the camera so they can transmit the aperture and the focusing distance, which are really important for the IBIS in the X-H1. So having these contacts and this information coming to the camera, you can get the five axes of the camera working in body. And it also allows for lens correction profile to be communicated to the camera so that they can correct barrel distortion, shading in the corners and stuff like that. Next up is a feature that allows you to have bigger icons on your screen, whether it's for the film simulation, the shutter speed, aperture, and everything. They will be displayed bigger on your screen than before. So you can get the big ones if you have trouble seeing these little icons, then you can have them set bigger. Next up, you have the autofocus performance that's been enhanced by a new algorithm, which make it snappier and tracks better the subject when you're either photos or video. And then also when you put it to the smaller point, now it's actually able to use phase detection on these smaller points, which before was using contrast only. Next up, as you might know, the X-H1 features Bluetooth built in, so there's been some improvements there. So before you could only pair the camera with one smartphone, now you can actually pair it to up to 7 devices. So you can have your iPhone and your iPad working in Bluetooth with the X-H1. But as well, there's been some improvement on the app itself and the camera firmware. So you can now trigger the camera using your smartphone as a wireless trigger. So that's really cool. That's something that's been asked and it's been done now. So that's really nice because you really always have your iPhone in your pocket. So you always have that wireless trigger. And it's not like a remote control of the camera where you don't see your screen anymore. It's really just a trigger itself. So you can still see in the back of the camera and just trigger it from a distance. And the last one would be in the customizable options for your buttons. There's been a new option where you can actually put the IS mode to a function button so you can quickly change if you want it on all the time, only when shooting and stuff like that. So you can just set it to one button and just access it quickly. So there's all these documented official improvements, but sometimes there's some things that's been done that are not really said. And one of the big thing to me is actually the improvement now of the auto ISO when shooting in video. So before, if you would be shooting video and you were in auto ISO and you would come from a dark spot to a brighter spot, so for example, from indoor to outdoor or vice versa, it would be like some steps between the ISO. But now, that's been improved and it's really like seamless. You can just see that transition being so smooth. So I think that's really, really good. And I think Fuji should have put it in the official enhancement that's been done to this firmware actually. All right, so this is gonna be it for this video. I hope you enjoy it. And I strongly recommend you make sure you have the latest firmware for your Fujifilm camera. To do that, just put a memory card in there, hold the display back button and power on the camera and see which firmware your camera is currently at and compare it to the latest version on the FujifilmFirmware.com website. And if it's not up to date, download it and bring it up to date, because you might be missing out on some really cool features. So if you should have any questions, please leave them in the comment section down below. Make sure you follow us on Twitter and Instagram, and until the next time, c'était Francis pour les Fuji Guys.